So 343 is finally listening to us, and I'm pretty happy about it, but also kind of disappointed, and I'll tell you why in a few minutes. So to keep it brief, the community manager at 343 put out another tweet, as he does to address a lot of the issues, and he is saying that we will get SWAT and free-for-all playlists before the end of the year, essentially. They won't make it for a release date on December 8th, which... kind of weird to me. And they also said they're working on a Slayer playlist, which will be there after the holiday season, so like January or so. I'm glad to see that they're being open and actually addressing these issues with like the XP and the progression and also these playlists and stuff, but it just doesn't feel like enough. And I don't know if I have the right to complain here, but I'm still going to just voice my opinion. This game has been in development for 6 years. Why are we missing all this stuff? Like, I don't mean to like be mean or anything, but like, what have they been doing with that 6 years, you know? Because like, these things that are core components of the franchise in general aren't even there on launch day. Forge, I get it. Forge is a massive thing. There's even like scripting and stuff now, and just AI, it's crazy. So I get the delay for that. But to put in simple playlists, or even more variety of maps, there's only 10 maps, or just anything, like, I just don't understand how it's been in development for so long, but like things like that haven't been added. Now, I don't know all the behind the scenes issues or anything, so like, I'm probably being unfair in my judgment, but it's just like issues I'm having. The playlists are very, you know, clamped together, so they will be adding some of them, but like, why were none of these planned for release date anyways? Like, these are staples in the franchise. You would think they would be there in general. And on top of that, on top of the lack of game modes and playlists, so like the lack of maps too, and the weapons and the vehicles, there's hardly any vehicles, I feel like. The weapon sandbox is a lot smaller, and even though it can grow over time, just like the vehicles and stuff, it's not there for launch day. And it just feels like they're releasing the most bare bones game they can on December 8th. Besides the campaign, and this is like worse than how Halo 5 launched, to be honest with you, and I don't like that very much. Like, with the maps, they all feel kind of generic. Like, all the outside maps are all the like Pine Woods aesthetic of Zeta Halo. Like, I get for the campaign, maybe it was too big or too much to do different biomes, but like for multiplayer, you couldn't make a snow map or desert map. I guess Behemoth's kind of a desert map, which I really like Behemoth, by the way. Great map. But I just feel like they could have had more, or at least more diverse ones. But anyways, there's my little rant about this. I hope these things can be added in the near future and we don't have to wait forever for them. And they are addressing a lot of the issues like playlists and stuff. And I'm sure these things will be addressed over time. Obviously, it is a live service. And I don't think that should be an excuse to have missing content, but... we'll get it eventually, I suppose. But yeah, just a little quick news update on Halo Infinite. Campaign does still launch December 8th on Wednesday, and I'm very hyped for that, so. Probably not going to make a video playing it, but I will most likely make a video, like, reviewing or talking about it, or my experience with it or something, because, you know, it's something I hold dear to me, so I'm very hyped for it. But yeah, that's about it. See ya.